Welcome to Codedeveloper. Today we see the topic is queue. So it is a data structure concept. So queue, it is a non-primitive linear data structure and a subclasses of list data structure. It is an ordered homogeneous collection of elements in which elements are appended at one end called rear, and elements are deleted at other end called front end. It follows first in first out mechanism, in which elements comes from the first will be removed first. So first come, first out. Two operations are frequently carried out queue. They are insertion and deletion process. The insertion operation is possible only when the queue contains elements less than the capacities it can hold. The deletion is possible when the queue contains at least one element. So it is a terms and conditions. So what are the disadvantages of simple queue? If more elements are deleted, the value of front will be increased, and as a result, beginning position of queue will be empty. Therefore, if you try to insert a new element, no element is inserted, because new elements are always inserted from the rear. And if the last locations of queue hold an element, even though space is available at the beginning of queue, no elements will be inserted. The queue will be treated as overflow. So it is a drawback. So it is a disadvantages of queue. So queue using pointer. So how to using pointer representation in queue? So pointer implementation of a queue can be carried out is similar to array implementations. This dynamic implementation create node at runtime. Accordingly, insertion deletion operation can be done in this queue operations. Create a queue, checking queue either full or empty, then initializing a queue, insertion, deletion, then display. So types of queues. The major disadvantages of queue is when the rear point reaches to the end of the queue, that is array, no more elements can be added in the queue, even if the beginning memory locations of array are empty. To overcome the above disadvantages, different types of queues can be applied. So what are the different queues? So circular queue, so D queue, so that is a double entered queue, then priority queue. So in these three kind of process are overcoming in these kind of drawbacks. So it is an example. So that is a static implementation queue example. So the data members are defined into the structure. Structure name is queue. So queue is called as the structure variable. So to check if the front and rear, if the condition is true, means it returned 1, otherwise it returned 0. So it is a remove part empty of equal to 1. Equal to 1 means it is underflow. Else q dot front double equal to 99. So the front value is 0, otherwise the front value is incremented with 1. The data should be inserted for the corresponding locations. The data should be removed for the corresponding locations. Then show the information. If empty of equal to 1 means the queue is empty. Otherwise, to display all the information, that is a queue format. That is a first in first out format or last in last out format. So how to insertion the value to the queue? So it is a function for insertion operations. If q dot rear part is 99 means the rear part equal to initial value is 0, otherwise the rear part is plus plus. If rear part equal to front means it is overflow, otherwise we are insertion the for the given data. So it is a main function. Here in this main function are executed the first of the statements. The switch statement, the case is 1 means we are inserting. If the case is 2 means remove the data. If the case is 3 means to show the information from the queue. The next one, the queue, another one queue example. So it is used for pointer representations. Here struct list, it is a structure name, it is a data members. So structure within the structure, so struct list, it is pointing to the next address. So type def, it hold, we can, it is used for to cloning the data type. So that is struct list. So node, so node is on object name. So node asterisk front, then asterisk rear, it is two objects from the node. So front and rear parts. So it is a memory allocation parts, allocating and space. These allocating space are stored into new variable. Then you enter integer data. The data should be stored into I variable. New equal to next, that is new points to next equal to initial value is null. The new information equal to, that is inserted data, should be stored into the new information. To check the condition, front double equal to null. If the condition is true, front equal to new, then rear equal to new, that is a data. Otherwise rear next equal to new. So next value should be entered into the representation, then rear equal to new value. If you want to delete the information, means first of all to check the conditions, front not equal to null. If the condition is true, so temp equal to front, you are assigning the temp value equal to front, then front equal to front points to next address, then free of temp. So free of temp is used for to remove the corresponding datas, that is the pointing datas. So in this process or display, all the information, that is all the data items from the queue, that is the first in first out order. It's a main function. One is insertion, two is deletion. If you are using three means to display the to display all the data items from the queue. Thank you.